Thank you. people asked. They said, you guys have continued to tour for a long, long time. But why no dates in the United States? There was a handful of promoters that believed in us. And one of them's here tonight. But throughout the United States, and I talked about this on the first four shows of this tour, and I'm going to talk about it every night, because something unusual, some phenomenon has happened. About 3 years ago, you guys all got together and started petitioning promoters all around the United States. And it was not hundreds of you, it was thousands of you. And in all my years of doing this, I have never seen or heard of anything like this that's ever happened. You guys use social media to make this happen, and I thank you for that.
Yeah.
something you guys wanted to hear?
Thank you. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
the unofficial anthem of this year's state of Texas.
before I begin, I would like to introduce the president of the PMRC, Pam Howard, and our treasurer, Sally Nevius. The Cash Music Resource Center was organized in May of this year by mothers of young children who were very concerned by the growing trend in music toward lyrics that are sexually explicit, excessively violent, or glorify the use of drugs and alcohol. Our primary purpose is to educate and inform parents about this alarming trend, as well as to ask the industry to exercise self-restraint.
I can only say that I find your statement to be boorish, incredibly and insensitively insulting to the people who were here previously, that you could manage to give the First Amendment, the Constitution of the United States, a bad name, if I don't think you have the slightest understanding of it.
Senator Gore's wife talks about bondage and oral sex at gunpoint on the CBS Evening News. People in high places work on a tax bill that is so ridiculous, the only way to sneak it through is to keep the public's mind on something else. Porn rock.
In our society or anywhere else in the world, I've had in my experience two encounters with a sort of censorship. My song Rocky Mountain High was banned from many radio stations as a drug-related song. This was obviously done by people who had never seen or been to the Rocky Mountains and also had never experienced the elation, the celebration of life, or the joy in living that one feels when he observes something as wondrous as the perceived meteor shower. Obviously a clear case of misinterpretation.
So it's not really a wild leap of the imagination to jump to the conclusion that that's about something other than surgery or hospitals, and neither of which I mentioned in the song.
No, it's not a wild jump, and I think what I said at one point is that songs allow a person to put their own imagination, experiences, and dreams into the lyrics. People can interpret many ways. Miss Gore was looking to say that masochism and bondage, and she found it. Someone looking for surgical references will found it as well.
I got this glint in my eye when I'm performing, which keeps people on balance. And when they're asking, is he or isn't he serious about this? Those people have obviously never seen that glint. I mean, how could any grown man walk around with a 12-inch sword between his legs and take that seriously?
Making
Thank you.